Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So we'll start the lecture. So last time we had seen order list, HR tag, heading tag. So all of you have tried them at home? Practice at home? Okay, we'll just see what we have seen in the last lecture. So ordered list. So ordered list, basically it is used when the sequence of items is important. So ordered list means it can be in any order. It can be 1, 2, 3, 4, capital ABCD, or Roman letters, capital 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. So for using this ordered list, one more, all of you can see the screen. You can see the screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so for using the OL list, we have to use one more tag called LI tag. It stands for list item. Okay, so basically whenever you write OL, and inside that if you write LI, so that many number of items will be there, and according to the attributes of OL that you are going to use. So what are the three attributes of OL tag we have seen last time? Yes, attributes of OL tag. Hello, you can hear me? So the attributes of OL tag are start, type, and value. So in the type attribute, what are the different values that we had seen? Okay, see, we'll see the attributes of OL tag again. So three attributes are there: start, type, and value. So by using the type attribute, you can change the sequence. That means if you want capital ABCD, you have to write A. If you want small ABCD, write A. By default, if you don't write anything, it will be number one. If you just write OL and list item, these four things, automatically it will be number 1 to 4. Okay, then start allows you to change the start value of the list. So we'll just see the examples once again. Now see the code here is there and the output is shown here. So if you write type is equal to A, type is an attribute. So attribute has to be always written inside the tag. Now this is the OL tag and this is the attribute. So if you write capital A, the sequence will be like this: A, B, C, D. If you write small a, it will be small ABCD. Now the next attribute is type. Same attribute type. Here we are written for A. Now here we are writing for Roman capital letter I. Okay, so if you write capital I, so see the Roman letters are there, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now the next attribute we are going to see is start. Okay, now see, in any tags you can have more than one attribute. Some tags have got no attributes, some tags have got 8 or 9 attributes also. You can use all the attributes in that tag. Now see here, two attributes are there. One attribute is type, one attribute is start. So OL is the tag and the attributes are written inside. Type is equal to 1 means by default the numbering will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But since we are writing start is equal to 10, that means we have want to begin the sequence from 10. So the number starts from 10 and it will increment by 1 each time you write LI. Now see, start is equal to 10, I have written, so it will be 10, 11, 12, 13. If I write 100, it will be 100, 101, and so on. So the next attribute of type is value. Now see, some attributes can be written in the tag. Some attributes are there which has to be written in the different tag. Now see the attribute over here, value. So that I have written in the LI tag and not the OL tag. Now see why this value attribute is used. basically suppose you want to write some sequence of numbers and see 51, 52, 53, 54. So after this, you want to change the sequence. At that time, you can use the value attribute. So these are the consecutive sequence. After that, we are changing the value to 22070. So after this, whenever you write li, automatically it will be incremented by one each time. So all of you understood the three attributes of OLTAG: type, start, and value, how to use them. Last time I had shown you the demo of this. You can hear me?
Sir, how are part par explain karana start and OL, sir.
Start any value, na? Now see, OL is an tag, okay? And type and start, they are the attributes. Not type, why you are using? See, type, three types of types are there. See here, type means either it can be capital A, sequence, small a, numeric one, Roman letter I, or one. So this is I, sorry, this is capital I, a, small a, capital I, small I, and one. Means it will tell you the sequence in which you want the numbers. If you write capital A, it will be ABCD. If you don't write anything, by default, it will be one. Numbers will be there. And next thing, if you write capital I, so it will be in Roman letters. Roman numbers will be there, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now the next attribute is start. Suppose you want to start the sequence from 10, then type is equal to 1 means it will be numbers, and start is equal to 10 means the numbering will start from 10 and increment by one number for each li, 10, 11, 12, 13. Now the value attribute, basically why it is used, suppose a list is there with you and we want to change the sequence in between. Now see, the numbers are 51, 52, 53, 54. After that, directly 70 is there. So in any given tag, you can use n number of attributes. So this is an attribute. Type is an attribute. Start is an attribute. So I am telling here that you have to use the type 1. That means number sequence. And start with the first number as 22051. So it will start with this number. Increment by 1 each time whenever you write li. But see here, in this li, I have written value is equal to 22070. That means I want to change the sequence of the numbers and it should start from 22070 after HTML. So after this, it is starting from 22070 and incrementing by 1 each time whenever you write the next li. All of you got this?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so next we are going to see unordered list. Now basically, like I had told you before, in the question number 5, in which you have got two C++ programs, one normal C++ program, one C++ program based on class, and one HTML. So in the last part, which is of 5 marks, HTML code that you have to write. So either the output will be given, you have to write the code, or the code is given and you have to write the output. Now basically in the last question number 5, basically one question is asked based upon the table attribute and one question is asked based upon the ordered list and unordered list. Combination of both the list, one question is asked for 5 marks. So basically two types of list are there. One is ordered list, one is unordered list. Ordered list means what? In which there are some sequence or numbers or alphabets. There is some numbering to that. So that is called ordered list. Now ordered list is same to the unordered list, but unordered list means what? There is no sequence. They can be bullets or they can be some symbols. So all of them are having the same value. That is why it is called unordered list. Now unordered list starts with UL and ends with slash UL. It is similar to the working of ordered list. You have to use the li tag also in UL tag. It is similar to ordered list, but only the sequence is not there here. So that is why it is called unordered list. So the attributes of UL tag are type. So this type attribute in the OL tag, it was capital A, small a, Roman capital I, Roman small I, and number one. But in UL, the type is circle, disc, or square. Okay, by default it is disc. So these three values it will allow you, either circle, disc, or square. Now we'll see how it looks. Now see here. All of you can see the screen. Yes, you can see the screen. Yes, can you see the screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now see UL tag, how it is used. So attribute is type. Now see UL type is equal to disk, and these are the three list items, LI, LI, and LI. Now see disk means what? A rounded circle which is darkened. Okay, a circle which is darkened. Okay, or it is colored. Now see three items are there, Rahul, Santosh, and Dinesh. So this disk is there, DISC. All of you can see these three. Now for type, there are three values. One is disk, one is circle, and one is square. So only these three values are there. If you write rectangle or any other geometrical figure, it will not work. Only these three are there, disk, circle, and square. Now see how the output looks. Circle means a rounded circle, and square means a normal square. So these are nothing but the bullets. So that is why it is called unordered list. So there is no sequence in the order. So all of them are having the same order. Next, all of you can see on the screen.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now, in the exam, like I told you, mostly the output is given and you have to write the code. Now this is the output that will be given in the question paper, and you will have to write the HTML code for the same. Now what is the first line?
Modern College.
Where it is located? On the left, right, or center?
Center.
And what is the size of it? Whether it is a normal font or whether the size is increased?
Bold.
Bold. Size is increased.
Size is also increased and bold. So which tag you are going to use here to make it bold and line large center. Size? We have seen the heading tags H1 to H6. So we'll write the heading tag for Modern College.
H1.
And align is equal to center because it is aligned to the center. Now next three, see type of courses in undergraduate level, type of courses in postgraduate level, type of language departments. So these are normal lines and which we are having unordered list. FYBA, BCom, BSc, MSc, MCA, MCom. So all of them are having different attributes. First one is having type is equal to circle. Next is having type is equal to disk. Next is having type is equal to square. Now we'll see the code, how it is written. See the first line for beginning any HTML document is HTML, head, then title. You can give any name here, which will be the title of that web page. Close the title tag, close the head tag. Whatever you write in the body tag and the close body tag, that will be shown on the web page. See this web page I have written starting from here. And then it is starting from this side, okay? So see H1 align equal to center, Modern College. Don't forget to close the H1 tag, else what will happen? Everything will be in H1. See, this is only one line, Modern College, which is in bigger font. So that is why I have given here H1 align equal to center. The spelling of center should be T-E-R. If you write T-R-E, it will not work. and close the H1 tag. So next is the paragraph tag. See, this is a normal line, type of courses in undergraduate level. So I have just written P tag, type of courses in undergraduate level. So no need for ending the paragraph tag. So next is what? BA, BCom and BSc. So this is using, you should use OL tag or UL tag?
UL tag.
UL tag, and type is equal to circle. So see, UL type is equal to circle, list item FIBA. Don't forget to close the LI tag. Else, if you don't forget to close slash LI, if you just write LI, one more list item will be added and it will be blank. Now see, UL tag, I have closed this UL tag. Now next is again type of courses in postgraduate level. Similar to the here, type of courses in postgraduate level. Here instead of type is equal to circle, I have just written type is equal to disk. List item, then close this. And last one is type is equal to square, type of language departments. See P tag, then UL. And we have closed this UL tag, close the body tag, close the HTML. So you have to write after this, you have to start from this, which will be below this. Okay. So all of you understood how to write the HTML code for this output?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So next, see in the board exams, usually the left hand side, sometimes whatever the output is there, that is given. And you will have to write the HTML code. Sometimes the HTML code is given and you will have to write the output. Okay. Now for this example, we'll just see that the output is given to you and you will have to write the code. Now see here again, list of books, it is in bigger font. So you have to start with HTML head, title, close the head tag, start the body tag, and then you have to start writing the code. The first line is H1 tag, list of books. Don't forget to close the H1 tag, else everything on the web page, it will be H1. Now see, there is a line below this, which covers the whole screen. So it is not an underline tag, it is an HR tag. HR means to draw a horizontal line across the screen. So just write HR, it will draw a horizontal line across the screen. Now next three, see, these are circles. So that means it is an UL tag. You have to just write UL type is equal to circle, LI, LI, LI. So whatever are the contents, you have to just write. Don't forget to close the LI tag and then close the UL tag. Now next we are having the A, B and C. That means it is not UL tag, it is an OL tag. OL stands for order. That means it must be having some order like number sequence or Roman letters or ABCD. So these are the three values. So here you have to write type is equal to A, list item, list item, list item, close the OL tag, close the body tag. So all of you understood how to write the HTML code for the ordered list and unordered list? Yes, you can hear me?
Yes, sir.
So should we go further?
Yes, sir.
So usually in the board exams, these are simple exercises. So such type of exercises will not be asked. It is a combination of both the tags. So which you are going to see now. See, next is nested list. So till now, we have seen nested if statement last year, nested for. Which means what? We have to use one if statement within another if statement. Nested for means one for statement within another for statement. So here in HTML also, we are going to see the nested list. So it is nothing but the placing of one list within another. They can be used to present information as a menu, or if the document has to be indented. Indented means what? It will show some relationship. Okay. Now see here, all of you can see the nested list screen?
Yes, sir.
Now see, student and staff members, they are aligned, sir, on one line. And they are having the disk circle, which is colored. And name of boys, name of girls, name of male staff, name of female staff, they are aligned on one line. All of you can see?
Yes, sir.
Now we'll see how to write the code for this. See, whenever one tag is there, UL tag is there or OL tag is there, and you want to shift the, now suppose here students are there, and name of boys and name of girls, they are shifted by one tab inside, okay? So how to do this? Now see, the first line is what? HTML head, title head, till body, you have to write for every HTML code. Now see, UL type is equal to this, because student is having this, type is this, okay? Circle with colored inside, okay? Type is equal to this. Now what is the this list item? It is student, li, okay? Now see, when you write one UL tag within another UL tag, before closing the above UL tag, it will shift by one tab, okay? Now this is very important. When you write one UL within another UL, without closing the first UL, then it will shift by one tab. Now see, this UL is there, type is equal to this, LI is there. So I have not closed this UL tag. I have started another UL tag in this UL tag. So what will happen? By one tab, it will shift inside whatever you are going to write here. Now UL type is equal to circle, name of boys, name of girls. I have closed this UL tag. See, for this UL, I have closed this tag. Okay, the first UL tag was there, list item was there, so student has been printed. Then we are inserting another UL into this. UL type is equal to circle, list item, close this UL. Now see, it will shift by one tab here, and name of boys and name of girls will be given here, and here type is circle. So circle attribute will be displayed here. So what we have done here? So for the above UL, this is the first LI. We have not closed this UL tag. So for this list item, one more list item we are inserting, writing over here, LI staff members. So the UL is there, list item is there. Again, the list item is there. So the browser will know that this staff members, it is related to students. That means it should align on the same line as student. So we are writing the LI here, staff members. So what will happen after name of girls, staff members, it will again come back to its original position and it will be aligned with the student. Because see, UL type is equal to disk, LI student, LI staff members. So both of them are aligned on the same line. So again, inside this, I am inserting another UL. So when you insert one UL inside another UL, again, it will shift by one tab. So again, see, type is equal to circle, name of male staff, name of female staff. So it has shifted inside. And I close the UL for this UL. And this UL, I close for the above, top UL. UL type is equal to this. For this UL, I closed it over here. So this is how the nested list is used. One UL within another UL, it will shift by one tab. So all of you understood this?
Sir, shift sign color.
Yes, sir.
Shift
yes.
Dalil sanga.
Huh? Yes?
Shift dalil te sanga na. Ek ne.
See. Actually, whenever you write one UL within another UL, see, UL type is equal to disk. List item is there. The student will be displayed. So once you are writing one UL within another UL, it will shift by one tab, okay? So this name of boys, name of girls is there. You are closing this UL. Now this list item is there for the above UL. So again, it will come back to the original place like student and it will be displayed here. So once you have inserted another UL, again, it will shift by one tab. It will go inside list item, close this UL. And this UL you can see. So this is for the top UL. For this UL, this is the closing tag. So this is how it shifts. You understood?
Yes, sir.
Or today I show you one more example.
No, sir.
Now see how many UALs you inside within one UAL, that many times it will shift by one tabs. So I'll just show you one example of that. All of you can see this. Yes, all of you can see the output.
Yes, sir.
What you are seeing on the screen?
Yes, sir.
Student, staff, name of boys, girls, staff member, teaching staff.
And staff members and teaching staff, isn't it? Now see the yes. tabs. See, this is the first tab. Next is this tab and next is this tab. Now for creating this type of list, now see the code how we have to write. I'll just right click on the screen and just say view page source. So all of you can see this HTML code.
Yes, sir.
Now
yes, sir.
See HTML head is there. Yes, now this is the first UL. UL type is equal to this li li. See, I have written one more UL. Name of boys, name of girls, and one more UL, staff members, teaching staff. And I have closed this UL here, above here, UL here, and the first UL here. See, three ULs are there, first, second, third, and I'm closing this like this. Whenever you write one UL or one OL within another UL, without closing that UL, now see the output. All of you can see the output?
Yes, sir.
Now, all of you understood this UL, UL, UL?
Yes, sir.
Now, see what yes, will sir. Happen if I close this first UL here only. Okay? We'll just see what the output will look like. Okay? See, this code is there. I'll just change the code and you can just see the output. Yes, can you see the code?
Yes, sir.
Now see this first UL is there. All of you can see this? UL type is equal to disk?
Yes.
Now see, I am going to close this UL here. See, this is a new UL. So before this, I will just close this UL and you can see the changes, what it will happen. Okay. Now see, I close this UL here. Okay. And I will just delete one UL from the below. Now see the changes. Now see here, UL is there, UL is closed. Then the next UL is there. Now you can see the how the output changes. See, this was the previous output. So I'll just refresh this. And see, name of boys and name of girls, it will shift to the left side. See, I'll just say reload. You can see name of boys, name of girls, they are shifted here.
Yes.
And see, there is one space created in between after staff. Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
So when you write one UL, after that you close that UL, you open another UL, one space or line will be there in between. Now same thing we'll do after name of girls, okay? Now see, after name of girls is there, I am going to close this UL, okay? For this UL tag, I will close here. Here I close this UL. See, the first UL I have started here, closed here. Started here, closed here, started and closed. Now see how the output will look. See, again the staff members and teaching staff, after girls, one line will be inserted and this will be aligned on the same line. See, right click, reload. All of you can see the output?
Yes,
all
sir.
Of them are aligned on the same line. isn't it? All of you can see the output.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So, should you understand that how you have to use the UL tag? Suppose in the exam the output is shown here like this, then you have to write the code like this. If the output has shown that it is shifted inside, then you have to write the code accordingly, else you will lose marks. Now see, I am just deleting this UL. Again, I am deleting this UL. And after this, I am going to write. See, while writing it, it is not necessary that you write it how I have written. But if you write it in this way, then you will come to know that which UL tag you are close, just like C++. So it will be easy for you to identify the errors. Now see, the above UL I closed here, this UL I closed here, and this I closed here. Now see the output changes. See, this was the first one where we have written UL and then we have closed UL. Now see what will happen. See, this it has shifted by one tab each time. So if you write one UL within another UL, it will shift by one tab. Okay. All of you understood this?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now we'll continue with the. So nested list, okay? So this is the code that we have seen. See, UL type is here. And I have inserted another UL here without closing this UL. So that is why it has shifted here. And this is the next LI, staff members, UL, UL, and I have closed this UL. So it is aligned in a, so basically this UL tag, it is used, nested list is used whenever you want to align the feature, some your web page like this. Now next HTML code. See, some of the examples that I have shown here, so they were asked for the board exam for 5 marks. Now see here, network connectivity device, modem, hub, repeater and router. So this question was asked for 5 marks in the board exam. Now see how easy you can get 5 marks. But if you forget to write any tag, then you may lose 1 mark. Now see, network connectivity device, it is bigger than the, in bigger font than the below. So see, HTML head, title head, body, so that you have to write for every HTML code. Then the h1 tag is there. Now see here, it is not an hr tag. Hr tag draws a line across the screen, but it is limited to device only, network connectivity device. So that is why it is an underlined tag. So see, h1 I have written, then I have written u tag, then network connectivity device. Close the underline tag, close the H1 tag. So this line, it will be in bigger font size. I not aligned it to the center. So by default, it will be left and it will be underlined. Okay. Now see, again, this is a type of nested list. This is disk, this is square, sorry, circle. So what you have to write? One UL tag within another UL. Now see how we are written here. UL type is equal to disk, modem and hub. Then I have started another UL. UL type is equal to circle. So when you write one UL tag within another UL tag without closing the above UL, it will shift by one tab. Now see, repeater and router, they are shifted by one tab. So this is closing of this UL. And for the above UL, I close this tag. All of you understood the code? Of UL tag, nested list. Yes, you have understood or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir, understood.
So should we go ahead?
Okay, yes, sir.
Now this is an example. See, this was also asked in the board exam for 5 marks. Now how many, now which is the first tag that you have to write? Yes. After HTML head, title, and if you start the body tag, which will be the next tag that you will start from?
OL.
OL.
OL. Okay. And for that OL, which are the li?
History and OL.
Which are the three list items for the OL? Art, science, and commerce. Okay. And see the code here. A and B means again it is an OL tag. Roman 1 and Roman 2, again it is an OL tag. And this is an UL tag. So you can try writing the code for this. And let's see who can share the screen to me. I think all of you are using your desktop or some of you are using mobile. Yes. Okay, I'll just show you how to write the code for this. You have to just open, right click, open a new notepad, text document. Whatever you write in the body section, that will be only displayed on the web page. So I am going to just save this file, nested.html. The first tag was OL and type is equal to 1. So the first list item was arts. So which is the next tag?
OL.
All of you can see what I am showing on the screen?
Yes, sir.
See, first is arts list item, then type is equal to A and B. So we are closing this OL tag. And then next will be the next list item. The next again, it is an OL tag. So I'll just copy this and just make changes here. Type is equal to I'll write it in short here. Now the next list item. And last is the UL tag. Now we'll close the above OL tags. Now see, this was the output given. Now we have written this code. I will just save this. See, OL type is equal to 1, list item. So for this OL, this is the first list item. This is the second list item. And this is the third list item. And I am closing that OL tag over here. So inside this, see this I am OL I have written inside this OL tag. So it will shift by one tag here. Again, this is the next OL. And this is the last UL. So I'll just save this. See, nested is there. I'll just click on this. You can see the output. Yes. Can you see the output?